Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some more Let's Play This Here. Fucking Dishonored. Good job, Ethan. Good. I'm proud of you. That was an excellent intro. Top quality, top notch. No one's beaten that intro, mate. No, yes. Here with Dishonored, the Brigmore Witches. Still swamping around in the, filth and degradation that the, Witches of Brigmore live in. Don't know why witches feel like they need to live in filth, but apparently, I mean, this isn't even necessarily living in nature. I mean, you could maybe explain it as living in nature, but for God's sake, the woman's got, like, we've got no reflection, shit, but the woman's got, like, basically her own mini army over there. And yet, apparently, she can't, have them tidy up a bit. I mean, come on. I mean, yeah, it's a big place, but Christ, woman, you almost have to try to fuck a place up this badly. Given the fact that the plague hasn't been around this long. I think it's the plague that did this, anyway. I honestly don't know. Ah, I need a key. The West Wing is locked. If one lacks a key. Right, we're going for a hunt. Okay. That was a slightly curious situation. Start a new pair of boots tomorrow. Oh God, she even talked about eating toads. Yep, it's a little bit closer, dear, so I can pop in behind you. Hang on. That's exactly how far forward I wanted you to be. Like, and I... Oh, dear. You know, it's almost impressive how easily you people fall for the same trick over and over again. I mean, Christ, you'd almost think you were stupid. But that can't be. No. It can't be that you're stupid. No, never. Perish the thought that you're just fucking morons. Right. I am hoping that there is a key in here that I just missed. I mean, to my mind, if there was going to be a key for that area, it would be in this area. You know, given the fact that this whole... Well, it looks like this, frankly, is all I've got to say. No. No key. No key for me. No. Fine, I'll leave the room of terrifying, glowing, and unpleasant noise-making letters. Actually, no, that's a wall. That's just a solid wall. Just slowly, just fucking... my way into the fucking wall. Although, I wonder, find myself wondering how long I could do this before I'd get killed. Depends on how many witches there are here. So far, very few. They appear to have all fucked off. Rather dynamically fucked off as well. Well, no, they haven't all fucked off. I've killed most of them. I'm a dreadful liar. Me, aren't I? Good God. Yeah, they've all gone. I don't know where they went, even though you've, like, got, like, documented video evidence of me stabbing them up a treat. I get through here. Nope, so I can. I honestly wasn't expecting to have been able to get through that, but apparently I could. So am I in the West Wing now? He's tired, don't worry about him. Being that polygonal makes a man sleepy, I've found. Christ only knows what it does to an antelope. Never know where the launcher is for that trap. Is there a launcher? There must be a launcher. You wouldn't put a tripwire up if there wasn't an actual launcher to fire anything, would you? Well, you might if you just basically want to try and spook people. Not spook people into not trying it at all. Arguments could be made. Okay. That was an unpleasant sound. Quite a potently unpleasant sound. Is that Emily? Is that what Emily is supposed to look like? This woman's supposed to be a great painter. She clearly hasn't finished that. Now the paint is finished, I will sit in the young lady's skin and wear her face like a mummer's mask. Have a look on those little spells, we'll put the child on the throne. But it's me they will be crowning. Delilah, the kitchen girl from Dunwall Tower. They call me Sir Glover's apprentice, but whose paintings reach through to the spirit? Mine. They will never know their blunder, but I'll be sure to whisper it into their ears at their executions. My follower will bear the lantern to the gallery in order to tear open the way to the void. There I will use the painting to complete the ritual. My walk into Emily's flesh must be undisturbed. Which one has other uses?
So Delilah wants to use Emily to become Empress.
I thought that was fairly apparent. Fine. Oh, presumably I have to use the lantern to illuminate the actual painting, rather than that awkward sketch being the actual painting. Which, quite frankly, would be depressing, because it's a shit painting. Oh, hello. Ah, that explains the unpleasant sound I heard. It's one of you horrible beasts. Oh. Sorry, love. Sorry to you too, love. Sorry I did have to blow you up, but frankly, I'm starting to run out of patience already. Oh, this is the thing that always ruins me in this game, is I do. It's the reason I can't do too many stealth. It's the reason I can't play too many stealth games that well. I run out of patience like nobody's business. Oh. There was another West Wing key on the other side of the door. It does make one wonder exactly how anyone else was ever expected to get in or out of there, but eh, what are you gonna do? Such is life. Such is the way ridiculous buildings are laid out by the presumably dead architects of old houses. Actually, having said that, I don't know whether or not, I say houses in the sense of, not fond of rats, then, it would appear. Then again, no one is in this town. I am wondering exactly what set them off into that corner. It must have been the body that I left there. It's been like distracted into the corner by the fact there was a dead woman there. Good. Fun. Educational. Oh. Oh my. I don't like this. Where's she gone? Oh, there you are. Lovely. Yes, set the lantern near the painting. Let's see how this goes. Fine. In we go. Let's go to the fucking Dishonored equivalent of the fucking Page Master film. Hey. Oh, hello, outsider.
You have many talents, Daud, and they've served you. Delilah's talents are quite different.
Yeah, I've noticed. Although, fucking witches' talents aren't.
She creates images, but she does more. She captures spirit. She insinuates her will into her subject, whatever it is. We're witnessing her masterpiece, and perhaps yours as well. You see it now. Emily's life hangs in the balance, and Delilah's, and the fate of an empire. The end is coming. And it's been glorious to watch you throw your will against the machinery you set into motion. All things end. All things burn to ash. But you, my friend, burn bright.
Right. Very well, outside. I'm still jumping in the hole. There we go. Not so much a leap.
Wait. Time to see what you've really got, Delilah.
Given the fact that she's kind of a wizard, basically, we're just a jumped up assassin. She appears to essentially be a fucking wizard. We may be, unfortunately, the odds are stacked against us, I fear. Okay. Statues of Delilah all over the place. Ah.
That I see.
Emily Caldwin, daughter of Jessamine Caldwin, heir to the Empire of the Isles. I call out to you.
Would any painting work for Delilah's ritual? I wonder, this painting might be useful.
The tones of your flesh I tempered, the pendicillin chalk. The same loom that spun the fabric of your dresses made this canvas. I took my brushes from the hairs of your own scalp. Emily. You cannot ignore me. My power is too deep. My reach too long.
Go away from the painting, love. Wait. Oh, dear. Sorry.
Brush touches paint. Brush touches canvas. Brush touches void. And now I see you, Emily Caldwin. I breathe your breath.
Let's just sit and watch, see what happens.
What you do. The bright mornings in the pub. I feel the cold night air of the ruin where you sleep. And the stink of the river. Image strikes the eye. Eye touches the mind. Mind touches the void. And your lost mother, for your caretaker, Callista. I feel your fear in the night, Your hunger to learn, to become someone important. My hunger too. My fear. You are becoming mine. We are nearly finished. Close your eyes, Emily. Sleep forever. Feel the void open beneath you. Make room for me. Give in to me, Emily. Give in to me now! Paint flows. Blood flows. Life goes. Out with the old, in with the new.
You can tell this was literally just made this long so we had time to intervene. Rather than sit and watch. There were clearly no... Like... Oh, no.
It is complete. I am... What? What's happening? This is all wrong! What am I becoming? Outsider blood? Is this some trick? Daud!
Yeah. That was unfortunate, wasn't it? Kinda sucks to be you. Really. I don't wonder where she ended up, though. I didn't actually get a good look at that picture, so I don't know. We still got high chaos, so fuck it, whatever. Enter. And we go back to Daud's hideout. He was me thinking we were at the end.
No one will ever know exactly what it took to save Emily Caldwin from a living death as Delilah's puppet. No one except the outsider, who watches everything and thinks his own dark thoughts and speaks to few in any generation.
It's odd given how many people worship him.
I've learned that our choices always matter. To someone. Somewhere. And sooner or later, in ways we can't always fathom, the consequences come back to us. I came from Sirkonos to Dunwall as a boy. Made my living as a killer. One of the few who've heard the outsider's voice. I murdered an empress. But saved her daughter, who will one day rule the Empire. Those were my choices. I'm ready for what comes.
Do we actually have to fight Carvo? Oh, no, we just auto lose in the cutscene. Fair enough.
I have one more surprise for you. I asked for my life when I killed your Empress and took her daughter. Something broke inside me. Now I want nothing but to leave this city and fade from the memory of those who reside here. I've had enough killing. So my life is in your hands. Make your choice.
You make an eloquent plea for a man with innocent blood on his hands. It's a shame Corvo doesn't know.
I imagine the low chaos version is what
Daud. The legendary assassin spent his last days doing whatever it took to save.
Yeah, I imagine the low chaos version is the one where you survive and this one we're gonna die. Just guess.
Bridge prison, faced down gang leaders in the terrors of Brigmore Manor. And with the end coming, you cut a savage swath through Dunwall. Blood and terror for the fate of the Empire. A story never to be told. And you leave the ending up to Corvo. That's courage. You make your own choice and accept the price.
I'm pretty sure we're about to get a first person stabbing through the neck. Yep, as I thought. I am pretty sure that the low chaos version would have Corvo spare us. I'm not sure, I'll have to look it up, and I suggest you, ladies and gentlemen, look it up as well, or possibly go through the game yourself, take the low chaos options, entirely, yeah, do it. Give it a go, give it a look, give it a try. Dishonored, the Brigmore Witches. And with that, we finish the, well, everything story-based about Dishonored 1. Though, I do understand that Dishonored 2 is a thing that's going to be happening at some point, so I may cover that at some point, but no promises. Right, again, I think I'll give my thoughts on Dishonored the Brigmore Witches. largely, it suffered from the same issues I had with it, that I had with the Knife of Dunwall, that being probably because, let's be honest, really, I think the Knife of Dunwall and the Brigmore Witches were possibly supposed to be one DLC that ended up as two shorter DLCs, because they're the same storyline and you carry over your character from one to the other, you know what I mean? Yeah, so I thought the fact we were playing a voiced character with a definite personality was an issue. Like it in The Knife of Dunwall. Though it must be said, I do think that this one did actually, to a degree, solve one of the issues that I always had with Dishonored, and indeed Dishonored 2. That being the fact that you could very easily... Not Dishonored and Dishonored 2. Dishonored and The Knife of Dunwall. Sorry, I'm ill still. A bit slow. But yeah, the problems I had with Dishonored and its first DLC was that you could run through a place and basically just melee your way through it for the most part. It did solve that by having the Brigmore Witches, who are actually quite an issue to have to fight. I mean, you can fight them in melee, but it is quite difficult. Like, surprisingly difficult. Although, this and the last one did have less actual enemy variety. Because obviously you didn't have, like, the walkers and that kind of thing, and the various different kinds of city guard, really. You had two kinds of city guard, and then just thugs, and then the witches, and then dogs that you have to hit the heads of. Enjoyable. Worth the relatively small price I got them for. I believe I got the first one when it was on sale and the second one when it was free. So yeah, they're not as good as the main campaign of Dishonored, but a nice addition if you want some more fun in the world of Dunwall. But that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Sardwish Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Oh, there's a fucking Billy Lurk thing as well. Apparently. Is there, or is that... Oh, that's it. Just reminding that you let Billy Lurk live, apparently. Fair enough. Right, bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that. I could have been having a really shitty day when I recorded that. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. Anyway, just here to say that I have a Twitter account that you can follow if you want occasional updates of random thoughts from me, and that if you're feeling generous, feel free to donate to my Patreon campaign. Every penny donated there makes life easier for me generally and slowly goes towards me getting a better gaming PC. Well, that's that. It's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the Sideways Thinker. Do not seek the Pardoner.